Welcome back to Let's Play Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're now headed towards the Ocean View Hotel. And all of a sudden, we got spooky music indeed. You need a lockpick skill of 10 to get in here otherwise. Now from what Therese told me, ghosts are harmless. And this is the only way here because this place is closed down, or the construction crews having fled because of the, I guess, supernatural phenomena going on around here. I heard a sound to my left. Don't hear it now. Spooky already. So is this like a construction trailer or something? Oh. I heard that. Ocean House front door key. What? Alright, so this thing is driving itself, okay. You can't do that, I need to hack into the computer. Oh, I can't. I can't get in the computer. Take that. Oh, you've got that crawling insects music type cue or whatever. Ocean House Hotel. I can't take that key. Alright. Why not put just one key on there, then? Wasting gas. So who died here that's now haunting this place? I can walk up this? No? No. Can I go in this? No. Can't climb the tower now. Alright, let's go in. You break this one? How about this one? Alright, I'm a little apprehensive at this point. Therese, I'm gonna kill you. Saw the figure over there? I did. this place is pretty haunted. Sure, it's just one ghost here? So she needs me to collect a belonging from this ghost. Tear the place apart if I have to, kind of thing. Elevators. Yeah, not operational. Ding! Shining going on over here.
He's
here. Oh! I saw that! Of course I saw that. Oh! Yeah, you really don't want me around here. Grand opening. Santa Monica celebrates the new Ocean House Hotel. This must be quite an old paper. Spooky going on? I can't throw things around too? Come on, I want to partake of stuff. Oh! Hey! Harmless. I could have been injured there. Difficulty of 8. Well, maybe I'll find a, what do you call it? A key for it. What we got here? Power status. First floor, second floor, third floor, elevator, basement, contraband systems. Well, power's apparently, yeah, not working. Not surprisingly. Oh. We've got hell beyond here. So I guess we're going this way. Alright. Ugh. I'm not liking this right now. So what? I guess ghosts don't do laundry. Makes sense. Nothing's going on in here. Nobody's home. Oh. You are one busy ghost. It's coming from this? Well, I can't interact with that. Oh. Ghosty? Oh Hotel Hell. Child's severed head found in hotel laundry room. Close that. I'm not ready to go through there yet. Thank you. Hey, I know that sound, that closing sound. Is that a stock sound? It just sounds so familiar right at the very end, that cling. Oh, I can move that whole thing. Come on! Oh, that's the door that was locked. Okay. Oh. Boiler room key. This key is labeled boiler room. Is this the boiler room? Guessing so. Have I been everywhere else before I go in the boiler room? There's the boiler room. Yeah, I think I've been everywhere else down here. I do want to make sure I check that other hallway that I was going to look in before I decided to go up the stairs and crash through. Is this something? No? Okay. Yeah, boiler room. Alright. Oh, that. Yeah. This way. Oh, ghosty, give me your one of your belongings. That's a very creaky door. I'm a vampire. I can still be affected by heat, extreme heat. I know that much. No, it's not gonna do anything. Can't mess with this stuff. What's it say? I love killing. Do not open ever. Lindsay is the bomb. Stop prison rape. The American tradition. What does that say? Bisden's? I want to open it, but I can't. I don't know how. I'm pretty sure this gun's never going to make any difference, but I feel better just holding it. Just in case she was wrong, and the ghost can harm me. Am I gonna die if I stay here? Should I be running? Hurt. What? You said the ghost was harmless. Oh my god. What? One more. Harmless, she says. I think Jeanette's my favorite. Out of the two of you. If you don't call that truce, your butt is toast here. How do I get back up? The elevator. The elevator apparently works now. If we're gonna trust the elevator, we'd be a complete idiot. Yeah. Was that? Oh, hi. How you doing? nobody's home. Ow. He is hurting me with this crap. Let me just check down the hallway. Because, oh. Oh. Wait. Well, I can go down the other way, can't I? Am I going to fall through here, too? I never went down here. Yeah, can't hurt me. Mm-hmm. Go in there. Oh! Will you stop throwing crap at me? He is? Ow! He wants to kill me? It's nice for him. Family missing. Fire department searches ocean house for remains. And who is he? Okay, I've got this thing. This thing follows me. Oh, Jesus. Do not follow me. I've got, like, a pet piece of plaster or something. You fall through there. You fall through here, too? No. Kind of looks like you would, though. Wait, wasn't there more down here? I think so. Another body. Police say second child was quote unquote chopped up like firewood. Yeah, police are very tactful around here, aren't they? Nothing gonna jump out at me over here. Okay. Okay, scary man on fire. And kids, and well, the one on the end looks a little like she's up to something too, I don't know. Oh, I didn't mean to. I wasted that. I wasted the blood, damn it. I was trying to exit out of that. Nothing's gonna break here. Well, you wanted me to come in here. I'm just supposed to see the drawing, that's it? Okay. Dead end here. Okay. Oh. Dodging stuff. Ow. Beg your pardon. Is that not a personal item? So cigars or something? Guess not. Take that. Oh. Upstairs key. A room key. I took a key. Too damn bad. Die, toy. A clock. I'm so impressed. Alright. Hey, girly. Oh, I'm supposed to go that way, I guess? Can I go in the other room first? Oh, a big spider web. I didn't see that. Ooh. I'm going in here first. I want to see it all. Now, there's a lot of people in the other room, apparently. Got a bunch of arguing ghosts. What's... Oh, those are... Ow. This is another dead end, I figure it would be. How do I get upstairs? Alright, there's a big party going on down there. I lost the key. Oh, the key is for here. You're quiet now, are you? Guess I'm jumping down. Or dropping down. Lloyd? Can you use a drink, Lloyd? Murder, suicide, Ocean House killer, possibly responsible for Inferno. Well, that makes sense with the kid's drawing with the person on fire. And evil at the same time. I think he's from hell. 666 proof. Uh-huh. For fictitious brand? Barbados rum. While it be, Mr. Torrance. I did not meet. Is that an elevator? No, what is this? This is an elevator here. Oh, maybe like a dumbwaiter. Before I take that. I eat ghosts like you for breakfast. Alright. Oh, God. Down? We can only go down, apparently. Straight to hell. The glitches fit right in, I gotta tell you that much. It's getting dark. Oh. I'm gonna be attacked by cookware. Diary.
Help me.
How do I help you? I'm gonna read your diary. You have discovered a journal in the Ocean House. According to its contents, a jealous husband murdered his wife and family because of a locket. The murderous ghost of the husband means to keep her trapped here forever with him, and she seems to be trying to help you find a way to free her. Okay. This is the charred remains of what looks like a diary. May 30th, 1958. Just arrived here at the Ocean House. We have a week-long holiday here in Santa Monica, and Ed has booked us a room for the hotel's grand opening. It's a wonderful place, almost magical. The children have been swimming all afternoon. May 31st. Next day. The first 2 days have been almost perfect, except that Ed can't seem to stop asking about the locket I received from my mother. He seems to think it was sent to me by some other admirer. Ed can be sweet, but sometimes his jealousy can get the better of him. Hopefully he'll feel better tomorrow. Why would he just not believe her that's from her mother? Next day, June 1st. Sun is out today, not a cloud in the sky. Ed seems a little on edge, keeps guessing as to who my new boyfriend is. Silly Ed. Not gonna be silly for long. 2 days later, June 3rd. There was a picnic for the hotel guests this morning. Quite a grand affair. Ed is in a dark mood. I don't know what I can do to reassure him that he is my one and only love. The only time he seemed to brighten up was when he was speaking to the groundskeeper. Boys and their tools. Next day, June 4th. We have only 2 days left, and thank God we're finally going home. Ed won't speak to me or the children, and I've found him more than once in the bathroom holding the locket and staring at it. I'm afraid he's suffered some sort of breakdown. I've told him we can go home, but he just shakes his head. He won't look at me. I just want to go home. Next day, June 5th. Ed left early this morning, and I haven't seen him since. I haven't seen him since. If I haven't seen him in another hour, I'm going to call the hotel manager. Against my better wishes, Ed Jr. went to look for him downstairs in the basement. I'm going to send Tiffany down to fetch him if... Wait. Someone is knocking at the door. Oh my God. Ed, covered in blood, coming to kill me. Locked myself in the bathroom. He's gone crazy. He keeps shouting we'll be together forever, and he'll never let me go. Someone please help... The writing trails off the end of the page. Okay, so do we have two... Well, he can't still be alive either, right? Jesus. That one's still shaking around. That we can't open. Alright. Good thing I have vampire regenerative powers. It's telling me to move it. I guess that's a hint. I mean, it's what I would have done anyway. I'm gonna crash through again, aren't I?
Be careful.
I thought he couldn't harm me. Unless he's still alive? How, though? Oh, crap. Are you kidding?